My name is Ken Franzese, and my wife and I attend the Rolling Meadows campus. I grew up part of a large Catholic family, and I attended parochial school and a Jesuit college, so I knew religion. It seemed very rigid to me. It just always seemed that that would require me to give up all the things that I was doing, that I was having so much fun, right? I've got 7 older brothers. I think our unspoken motto was go fast and take chances, right? If it had a motor, if it was dangerous, we said, let's try it. And I ran out of talent plenty of times and wiped out motorcycles or ATVs. I remember one time I was bragging to my mom about how lucky I was. And she said, you know, Kenny, I love you, but you're not that good. And she goes, and that wasn't luck or coincidence. She said, God has a plan for you. He has something he wants you to do in your life.
Ken and I met after high school. Our relationship grew and we got married. I believed in God only when I needed him. Pretty much ran my life on my own.
In May of 2018, a really good friend of mine bought a fully restored World War II fighter plane. And I've been a pilot for many years. And so he asked me if I would help him fly it back from LA to Chicago. We took off on May 6th of 2018 out of Torrance, California, about an hour into our second leg when we were over the most dangerous terrain of the entire trip. It was a 3.3 million acre Arizona wilderness. We suffered catastrophic engine failure. We immediately lost all thrust. You quickly come to the conclusion that there is no place to land and our only way was out. You don't get to push an eject seat in that airplane. You have to physically climb out. And when I stepped onto the wing, that's when I realized that this was way beyond my pay grade. And I said my first prayer, which is to help get Bron and I both safely out of that aircraft. My parachute got stuck up in the tree. I was suspended about 35 feet up in the air. And I ended up getting pretty badly injured on the way down, standing on the forest floor with broken bones and bleeding. Death is staring you in the face.
Our deal was that he was supposed to call me every time they landed or text me or something. And then I didn't hear from him. You know, I got up during the night, tried to text him and nothing, and got up in the morning, still nothing.
All I could think about was I wanted more time with my wife and our 2 daughters. And so I dropped to my knees and I started to pray and I surrendered. And I said, I need you to get me back to them. And you know, when you're trying to make a deal, as I sat there, I realized I don't have anything to trade him for. There's nothing I have of value that he needs. And then everything that my mom taught me all came back to me in that moment. And I realized he doesn't need anything from me. I know that. But what he wants for me is to surrender to him and to look for him. What happened next is beyond comprehension. Multiple miracles unfolded right before my eyes. One of the things that I specifically prayed for was a place to hide. He gave me shelter for the evening. The next morning when I walked out, I began praying intently for a path out. I needed a path. And I walked for probably a few hours, and all of a sudden I stumbled into this gravel road. Then about 100 yards up on the side of the road was Ron. Finding him in that dense area would be 1 in a million. I walked for a little ways past that, and there was a fire management crew that was driving up the mountain. As the truck came around the corner, I just lost it. You know, you start weeping. It's such an adrenaline release. And I told them the story, and both of their eyes just bugged out of their head. And they said, there's been a ton of plane crashes in these mountains. He goes, everybody dies. He said, you're the only guy who ever lived. And he goes, there's nothing on this mountain range. We're about 45 miles from town. And he said, in fact, we're down 2 trucks today, 4 crew. And he said, so we came to work Loafer's Bench, which is where you guys went down. And he said, we're not supposed to be here for a month, month and a half. It literally shook me to my core. The providence was just beyond anything you could imagine or ask for.
When we went out to Arizona to pick them up, he told me the whole story, all the prayers, everything that was answered. I 100% felt like God was pulling us both.
After we got back, Julie and I started attending Harvest Rolling Meadows full time.
Come Sunday, August 19th, of 2018. We were watching the sermon from the weekend before the summer revival.
And Greg Laurie was on, and he asked, he's like, have you shared your faith with anyone? And it just hit me like a ton of bricks, because I was struggling with that. I didn't know how to connect the dots. He said, you know, sharing your faith with someone, simply sharing your story, And it leads to your faith, right? It shows your faith. There were so many people that were coming up to me and going, oh, Kenny, I heard about this crazy airplane story. It's a God story. It's the story of my salvation.
So at the end of Greg's sermon, he asked anybody that would want to come up and accept Jesus as their savior to come up to the stage. I had my head down and I was praying. As I'm looking down, I see Ken's feet walking. And I followed, and we just both started crying in relief and elation all at once. The greatest thing that came from Ken's accident was us both committing our lives to the Lord, hands down.
God doesn't ask us to give up on life. He asks for a different set of priorities. He asks for our trust, my trust in Him. That wasn't the only battle that he put me through, right? My wife and I share challenges just like any normal couple does, but it gives me something to go back to, something to put things into perspective. What gives me peace today is that my wife and I both look to Christ first. We look to Him as our priority. It gives us that ability to move forward, knowing that we're not going forward alone.